Hi Capricorns, welcome to my channel. So in today's video, we are going to check out your person's current feelings and your current feelings towards your person. What is going on in this relationship? What are the obstacles for you and for your person as well? Plus, what actions you both are going to take in regards with the situation? Plus, the probable outcome of the situation. Alright, so all these things we are going to check out in my reading today. For my Capricorns, and this will be in detail, okay? So this will be a detailed reading for, I don't know, any one of you. Okay, let's go for Capricorns. What is going on? This is going to be a general reading. It may or may not resonate with all of you, so take what resonates and leave the rest, all right? And let's start now for my Capricorns. What is going on for my Capricorns, please? If you want to book an appointment, a tarot appointment with me, you can go in my Instagram page by the name The Magical Aura. The link is given in the description box below, so you can DM me over there, alright? Let's get started now. Okay. So let's see. So at the back of the deck we have the Two of Cups. So this might be a soulmate connection. You might feel that. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so on your energies, in your energies towards your person is the Sun card, Capricorn. So might be there is like, you know, towards your person you feel very much that you are the person who is more victim, you know, you feel victimized in this relationship because of the dominancy. Although the Sun with the Ten of Cups is a very positive energy, so towards this person, if not that, okay, if see one or the other person is dominating in this relationship, it can be you, it can be your person as well, but since because of this domination as well, I see that you take this person in a very positive note always, that this person is something, you know, might be a government job also related to this person. This person is in a government job, or you can be. What else do we have for my, wow, so Ten of Cups with the Ten of Pentacles with the Sun cards, all the positive energy, so I won't take it negative. Yes, this is a positive connection, the Nine of Pentacles at the back. So it feels like that, you know, towards your person you are very positive, Capricorn, that this person is stable, this person is mature, this person is a family man kind of a person. Okay, so man or woman, it can be either ways. Yes, towards your person there is strong positivity from your side. Yeah, so why is this Five of Wands is there in your energy towards your relationship? The relationship is a problem. I feel that the person is fine, but what about this relationship from your side? Why the Five of Wands is here in the relationship? The Sun again and the King of Cups is here. You feel that this person is really emotional sometimes when this person does not need to, and because of these emotions, emotional as in that either this person is really possessive towards you. Okay, so that is why this relationship, when it comes to this relationship, the conflicts start becoming higher and higher, the rate becomes higher, and because of this possessiveness, there are a lot of conflicts coming up in the relationship. Person is fine. When we talk about individuality, person is fine, but when the relationship comes, it is really tricky. Always, you know, you both might be fighting to each other. This person might be too mature to understand anything. Okay, so that is why you start feeling that I really need to be a little, you know, you really like, because Capricorn energy, you know, Capricorns are the mature people, but you still have that childish inner energy as well. And when it comes, you feel that this person is not entertaining that thing, or this person is not letting you entertain or you enjoy in that particular thing. Okay, let me clarify some more cards because I need some clarity for my Capricorns. Why is this happening? Why the King of Cups is here? Too many. King of Cups. Okay. King of Cups clarified by Knight of Cups and the Knight of Wands. Yeah. See, different energies are coming up. Knight of Cups with the Knight of Wands with the King of Cups. So it clearly means that yes, that mature level, that maturity level, you don't feel sometimes, you feel you want to be a little childish, you want to enjoy certain things, you want to enjoy life the way you want. But there's always some dominancy from your person that no, you cannot do this. Like a child, you know, is treated by his father. Like that kind of a situation sometimes come, and that is why it makes you feel, because Capricorns, they do not like to be ruled by anyone, and that is why sometimes this relationship goes towards the next level. Let's see why the Queen of Cups is here in your person's energy towards you. They're really emotional when it comes to you. Yes, emotions are high in this relationship. Eight of Cups. And what else we have with the Seven of Cups? Okay, this person is very emotional, but this person is not stable. That is what I am getting. You know why you are liking this person? Because of this person's nature towards you. And but it's always a, you know, it might not be the only thing that is like dominancy, which I was talking to you about in the relationship. Not only that, but stability is also one such thing in this relationship. Your relationship is not stable. This person is always, you know, this person might be really confused towards you when it comes to you. And it always, it is always like, you know, going far. Like, what is going on? It is not stable. Sometimes you want to leave. Sometimes you want to come back. Sometimes it's always like that. That kind of an energy, it is coming up. So that is why the problems are increasing, and that is why the conflicts are increasing day by day. Let's see why the Nine of Wands is there in your person's feelings towards this relationship. Although this person is confused towards, I don't know whether it's career issues, whether it's other person might be exploring other options, might be, not necessary, but yes, this person is always confused, okay? They're always not in their senses. It's like, I want to do this as well. I want to do this as well. I want money in my life. They want everything. But that is the problem. If you want everything, how will you focus on one thing? This person towards the relationship, Nine of Wands with the Page of Swords, they always want to, they are tired, but I don't think that they will let go of the relationship. They are really positive when it comes towards the relationship. They want to be, but they cannot be. That is the difference. Sometimes a person wants to do something, sometimes a person wants to be somewhere, be with someone, but they cannot be. Okay, so there's a huge difference in that thing. Let me check some more cards for this person's feelings towards this relationship. Seven of Swords. Okay, see? Yes. They want to be, but they cannot be because they are always trying to sneak out. Either they are hiding something from you. There's something, it's always fishy. You always find something fishy, or it's like something is going on with this person. Why this person is not telling me everything. You know, when you are in a relationship, you always expect that this person whom you are dating, whom you are dealing with, you want all the happiness and all the sadness to be yours as well. You want to communicate. Okay, tell me what is bothering you. Okay, we will discuss it out and we will talk it out. We will manage what we will handle. But no, this person is like, no, I cannot tell you. So it's always fishy. They're always hiding something or the other when it comes to the relationship. Okay, so let me check why the Fool energy is there in your obstacles. What you feel is the obstacle, the Fool. I think that you feel that this person is a little immature when it comes to dealing things, okay, because of the situation, because of their energy in there, with the Seven of Swords and Seven of Cups, so much confused. You feel that this person needs some you know, gardens, something like that. Garden. They need some garden angel. That is what you feel. They're always taking risks in life. And that is why you don't feel like, you know, you're not a risk taker. It's like, just go slowly and steadily. You are like that kind of people. The Fool clarified by the Hangman. Yeah. This thing is not going. You are wondering that why this thing is not moving, because of their energy only. Okay, so that is the answer for you. Why they are not moving forward? Because of themselves only. Because they do not want to move forward. They cannot, basically. Yeah. Because they do not trust you. They do not trust anyone. You know. They are emotional towards you. They want... they want a life, they want something with you, but still they are really skeptical when it comes to telling truths, telling what is going on in their life. They do not, you know, they do not trust anyone. Queen of Pentacles, for the clarification of the Fool and the Hanged Man. Yeah, this is you, Queen of Pentacles, Capricorn energy. You are very mature. You are a caretaker, we can say. Okay, you know how it works. You know, you take things practically, but they are not very practical. That is the problem which is coming up. So I feel that why the Sun energy is here with the dominance part, which I was saying, that you have to be dominant on them. You have to treat them as a child sometimes, which you do not want to, because they are like very kiddish sometimes. They are very much into like what is going on in my life, and you have to console them always. That is the issue. Why the Ten of Wands is there in their obstacle energy towards you in this relationship? Ten of Wands. They feel that this relationship is too much. Okay, when it comes to relationship, they just want to hang out together. They do not want to commit, Capricorns. That is the problem. Commitment is a problem. They just want to hang out. They want to be with you, King of Pentacles energy. They are happy, you know, spending money and everything. This is like just a fling kind of a thing for them. But when it comes to continuation of this relationship in a high level, when we talk about that, no, but there is no commitment towards you from them. No. Nine of Cups has come up in your card when it comes to taking action. What actions are you going to take with the Nine of Cups? What else do we have with the Seven of Pentacles? See, you want to invest your time. You are really, you show gratitude when it comes to this relationship. You are very grateful that you met this person. And you want this relationship to flourish to a next level. But for how much time you can keep on continuing or keep on, you know, just continuing this relationship? For how much time? For how much? That is like, you are tired of waiting. I see that you are waiting, you are waiting, you are waiting for your fruits to become, you know, to nourish, to ripe. But let me clarify some more cards. See, Eight of Swords energy is here. Yeah, strong. Yes, so you are happy with this person, but when it comes to this relationship, you feel like this is not going anywhere. You feel stuck in the situation, and then only you feel like, I should not do anything. If the universe wants me to be with this person, you know, that is why you are showing gratitude, that whatever is going to happen, it will happen in terms like whatever the Almighty will make it happen, whatever the Almighty wants with this person towards you, their actions towards you, okay, towards this relationship. Four of Wands. Well, this is a very strong energy. This is a marriage card, possibly, but what exactly? Tower with the Knight of Pentacles. Yes, this is a marriage card, but when it comes to continuation, this person has some thoughts towards you. you know, marriage thoughts, they have thought in that way, in that direction, they have that thinking, but they are really stuck in, either they are stuck in their past or they are just stuck over here. They are not moving anywhere. They are stuck in their career, they are stuck in the relationship, they are stuck in many things. And that is the reason of the destruction with the Tower card. Their thought process is really far, you know, you can't even imagine that far they are thinking with you. But we can just think, and you know, we just can't dream about anything, right? And not doing anything. Okay, so the Queen of Swords is there in the probable outcome energy. Why the Queen of Swords is here? It's not giving me good message over here with the Nine of Wands. Yes, and what else do we have? With the Temperance. All right. It's very much clear over here. So when it comes to the possible outcome, so this relationship is really, you know, either you or your person is cutting things off. It's more like your energy, because you are the mature one in this relationship. You are someone who actually thinks, who knows how to think, who can be practical when it comes to a relationship. You have to take it towards the next level, but if this is not happening, then that's it. We should just cut it off. Okay, so that is why you are cutting the relationship off, which I'm seeing in the probable outcome. And with the Temperance energy, it's looking to me like, yeah, everything needs some balance and some peace. So peace towards, you are going towards peace. And if you feel that, you know, you, it's not like you have you just lost a war or something. No, it's not about losing and gaining. It's about just being there till the time you both needed each other, and now it's time for the separation. That is a realization with the Temperance energy in your end, Capricorns. I think that your partner will also realize that at a certain time, but their energies are really coming up, really confused energies. They are going, you know, they are looking at some other direction and moving on some other direction. See how they are moving forward, but they are looking backward. So that is the energy of this person. They are always in some turmoil energy, always. See the Tower, the Knight of Pentacles at the same time. So you are able to understand what I mean, that this person's energies are high and lows they are going through, but your energy is coming so fixed. Queen of Pentacles, your energy is here. Nine of Cups is here. See how you are embracing yourself. That is your energies, Capricorn. So that is all from my side. I hope that helps, and we are going to meet you in the next video. Till then, bye.